How you doing?
Good, good.
So you just finished your gig at the Viper Theatre here in Florence. How did it work out? Did it go flat?
Oh yeah, for sure. Went really good.
It was a good gig?
Yes.
All right.
Yeah, I think people were talking a lot, but I really like when people talk at my shows. I spent a long time in my life not talking to anyone, and it didn't really get me anywhere. So I prefer when people talk. I get very, very nervous when people are very silent, so I like that.
So communication during your shows?
Not necessarily a communication. Sometimes it's just a bit of background and noise, mm-hmm. You know, a bit of the sound of people living their lives and hitting on each other and the local, I don't know, the just people communicating with each other. Yeah, for sure. I like that.
I'm gonna ask you straight away about your new album, Night Falls Over Kortedala, which is a town near Gothenburg. Am I right?
It's a suburb, yeah.
Okay. And the album went to the number one in Sweden. It got brilliant reviews on magazines such as Uncut and Mojo, and 9.0 points on Pitchfork, which is quite amazing. I think you must be proud of that, aren't you?
Yeah, and regarding Pitchfork, there's something, I think, when my record before that got 8.6, I immediately heard of something called the 8.0 Club. It's that every band that gets above 8.0 points immediately gets booked by all these festivals and distributors buy a certain amount of the records. And when I got 9.0, I started thinking, I wonder what that means, the 9.0 Club. And the day after I got this review, my frequent flyer card at Air France was upgraded from ebony to silver.
Gosh.
So I'm in the 9.0 Club right now. Great.
That's really brilliant, yeah.
Yeah.
Not bad. You only have to reach the 10 points club now.
Yeah.
You are in Europe now, touring. You've been in the US. You've got a new band. You change formations quite a lot. And how is it going? How is this tour going? How do you feel about it?
It's been amazing. The only problem is that I moved to Australia about 2 months ago.
You live in Australia now?
Yes. And I was kind of looking forward to just living there, you know, and just being there for some time. But I had to go here, and I was kind of depressed a bit at first. But as soon as the show started going, and every show so far has been really amazing, so I've been happy and kind of forgetting about Australia.
Okay. How did Canada do you choose Australia? What's life over there?
It's kind of relaxed and laid back, but you can kind of choose if you want that or if you want something else. And I think I just moved there because I have a lot of friends there. I wanted to get away from Sweden for a little while. And Australia is, of course, on the other side of the world.
Oh, yeah.
So I think as soon as I got down there, it smells so good down there. It smells like jasmine and all this exotic food from all over the Asian part of the world, and from Australia, and from all parts of the world. And I think as soon as I got down there, I started writing songs again, and they sort of had that feeling, they sort of had that summery feeling.
That must be a completely different inspiration from the one you had in Spain, am I right?
Well, I think that when I lived in Kortedala, the suburb, I never went out at all. I just stayed in my apartment and imagine the world outside, and that world was kind of, you know, that's the sound of Night Falls Over Kortedala. It's an imagined world outside. It's like world music, but from the point of view, just looking into map, and imagined world, and now it's the real world.
In what kind of world do you live?
A dream world?
Okay. I want to ask you about a time where you were not called Jens Lekman, but let me check, Rocky Dennis. You were known by this name. Can you tell me something more about it?
Rocky Dennis is my real name, and at some point I realized that Rocky Dennis was not a very good name in a commercial sense, and so I came up with this name, Jens Lekman, which is almost like the German goalkeeper, the soccer player, Jens Lehmann.
It's just one letter. Jens Lehmann, yeah.
Yeah, just one letter changed. And I thought I would attract a lot of soccer fans. So here I am, I'm Jens Lehmann now, and it's working out quite well.
Okay. Do you play soccer?
No, not at all.
You never played in the DFB, in the German national team, so?
No, I don't know anything. I play badminton.
Oh, you play badminton?
Yeah.
Okay. In Australia, they play quite a lot of badminton. Am I right?
No, they play cricket and stuff, but it's very close to Southeast Asia, where badminton is huge.
Yeah, in fact.
So I was in Malaysia a year ago, and they had the World Championships of badminton, and I felt like, yes, for once, someone is taking this sport seriously. Because in Sweden, it's considered, you know, a fag sport. It's just, you know, you play badminton. But for me, I think it's a very graceful and beautiful sport.
Is it true that in Australia, the banknotes are made out of plastic? So you can wash them in a washing machine?
Part of them are made of plastic. Okay. There's a little part just to make it harder for the counterfeiters.
That's a great idea.
Yeah.
I love that.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you very much for your time.
Yeah, thank you.
And good luck for the rest of the tour. I hope you enjoy it. And have a nice day in Australia then.
Thank you.
Come back home.
Thank you.